Assalamu alaikum, Nazreen. Today I'm in Parliament Square, Westminster, London, which is the main London attraction. And it is also the palace. It's also the place where many demonstrations and protests have been held. The square is overlooked by the various official buildings, legislature to the east, House of Parliament, executive offices to the north, the Whitehall, where the Prime Minister's House and the Scotland Yard office, the judiciary to the west, the Supreme Court, and the church to the south, the Westminster Abbey. The building looking upon the square include the churches, Westminster Abbey, St. Margaret, Westminster, the Middlesex Guildhall, which is the seat of the Supreme Court of the United Kingdom, and the government offices in Great George Street, serving HM Treasury and HM Revenue and Customer, and the political offices. And the east side of the square, lying opposite one of the key entrances to the Palace of Westminster, has historically been a common site of the protest against government action or inaction. But Parliament inserted a clause in Serious Organized Crime and Police Act 2005, making it illegal to have protest in Parliament Square, or indeed in large areas reaching roughly half a mile in all direction, without first seeking the permission of the Metropolitan Police Commissioner. This square is home to 12 statues of British Commonwealth and foreign political figures. They are listed here in anti-clockwise, beginning with the Winston Churchill. I will go through some of them. Sir Winston Churchill was a British statesman who served as Prime Minister of the United Kingdom from 1914 to 1945 during the Second World War, and again from 1951 to 1955. Next statue is David Lloyd George. He was a Welsh statesman and a Liberal Party politician who served as Prime Minister of the United Kingdom from 1916 to 1922. He held the office through the final 2 years of First World War, leading the British delegation at the Paris Peace Conference in 1919. This statue is of Field Marshal John Christian Smuts. He was a South African statesman, military leader and philosopher. In addition to holding various military and cabinet posts, he served as Prime Minister of Union of South Africa from 1919 to 1924. And then 1939 to 1948. This statue is Mr. V. Palmerston, who was a British statesman and was twice Prime Minister of the United Kingdom in mid-19th century. He dominated foreign policy during the period 1830 to 1865, when British stood at the highest. This is Millie Fawcett, who was an English politician, writer and feminist. She campaigned for women's suffrage by legal change, and in 1897-1919 led British largest women's rights association. This statue is of Mahatma Gandhi, who was an Indian lawyer, anti-colonial nationalist and political ethicist who employed non-violent resistance to lead the successful campaign for India's independence. Next statue is of Sir Robert Peel, who was a British conservative statesman who served twice as Prime Minister of the United Kingdom, 1834 and 1841, simultaneously serving as a Chancellor of Exchequer, as twice as a Home Secretary. This is Nelson Mandela. He was a South African anti-apartheid revolutionary political leader and philanthropist who served as the first President of South Africa. And he was country's first black head of state and the first elected in the fully representative democratic election. This one is Parliament House and the Big Ben, as you can see. This is a statue of King George the V. He was King of the United Kingdom and the British Dominions and Emperor of India from 1610 until his death 1936. He served in the Royal Navy until unexpected death of his elder brother in 1892, put him directly in the line of the throne. And this is Parliament House. As you can see, there's a lot of renovation work is being done. In the next video, I will take you inside, inshallah.